Right now, we have an exclusive interview featuring Hacksaw Jim Duggan and his thoughts on royalty.
The King Harley Race wears that great big crown on that bucket head of his, has that long purple robe flowing behind him, plays that high-stepping marching music to the ring, and likes to look down that bald pepper nose at all those people out there. Well, I'm sick and tired of it. The folks sitting in the arena are sick and tired of it, and you folks out there are sick and tired of it. And it doesn't matter where it happens, at the Slammy Awards or at the arena, the King is going down, tough guy.
Well, after those strong words from Hacksaw Jim Duggan, it was destined that Hacksaw Jim Duggan and the then King Harley Race would meet. And indeed they did. Right now, we're going to take a look at a series of confrontations between the two we will never forget.
We're back. Hacksaw Jim Duggan scheduled to wrestle next, and the King, believe it or not, still basking in his regalness. Oh, here it comes. Whoa. We may have a problem here. Just listen to what they're saying. The King is standing in the way of Duggan.
No, he's not. There's plenty of room for Duggan to go around him.
Oh, no!
What a cheap shot that was. He hit the King with the 2x4.
The King wants to get in the ring.
I don't blame him. What a cheap shot that was.
Look at that. That wasn't a cheap shot at all. Let's go for the replay real quick. Following in the matchup.
We're going to see right here. Harley Race is the guy who
You're
starts.
Not calling
Look
this
at
a
this.
Cheap shot?
No,
Look at
he
this.
Just pushed Duggan. Harley Race started it.
Oh, my.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from Glens Falls, New York, weighing 280 pounds, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. His opponent from Korea, weighing 271 pounds, Tiger Chung Lee.
Tiger Chung Lee. Harley Race still wants to get back into the ring. Tiger Chung Lee and Hacksaw Jim Duggan going at it. Duggan with a nice reversal. Tiger Chung Lee off. Bird body drop. Nicely done. And, ooh, my, did you see the way he drove the knee into the chest?
That was a beautiful knee drop. I will give him that. We got a problem back in the corner down there with the King.
Yes, we do. Race wants to come into the ring.
I can't blame him.
I can't blame Duggan for doing what he did.
I mean,
Harley Race just stood right there.
And you figure that warranted getting suckered by a 2x4, huh?
I wouldn't call that getting suckered, no.
You wouldn't.
No,
I would not. That.
Chung Lee to the ropes. Elbow misses by Duggan. Off the other one in a scoop. Big Hacksaw Jim Duggan holds him up there. And pumps him down with a slam. Nicely done. King wants to come back in, but here comes Duggan, shoulder block and a clothesline. A cover, and a count of three. Wait a minute, here comes the King. The King's coming back down.
We're gonna have some major problems, I think.
Tiger Chung Lee on his way out, and Duggan has in his hand at 2x4.
And look at the King, the King. Is not armed with anything.
He's looking for Bobby Heenan. That's what he's looking for. Here comes a chair.
Oh, now Whoa. It's even.
Oh, boy. Get hit. Let's maintain. Get him out of there. Get him out of there. Harley Race wants to get back in there. Get him back. Let's get the official word. Uh-oh. What's gonna happen here? You gotta be kidding me.
I don't believe it.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan had the crown and was certainly king for a day. It would not be the last he would hear from the then king, Harley Race.
Would you please welcome my guest, Hacksaw Jim Duggan? Hacksaw, I must say this has been quite a story. I guess it was a few weeks ago now when you knocked the king off his throne.
Well, you know, I'm one of just a few people that are sick and tired of King Harley Race coming down here, parading around, think that he's better than everybody else. This is America, baby. This is where all men are created equal. We don't have no royalty. We don't have no kings. And King Harley Race, I took your crown away from you. I took this fancy dad cape away from you. And I've got this 2x4 to make sure that I keep it away from you. What's this?
Hey, you got me right now. That crown does not belong to you. That cape does not belong to you. You're nothing but a thief. You understand?
Wait a minute now. From behind, Duggan, turn around. Harley Race is right behind you. Race striking with that 2x4 across his shoulders and again. Harley Race, oh no, he's wide open. Race delivers a blow to the midsection. Look at Heenan kicking over Hacksaw Jim Duggan down on the concrete floor. Oh no! Race jumping off the platform again, driving that 2x4 into the chest area, driving it again into Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Harley Race jamming that 2x4 into the midsection. No, look at this! Race with all his might just trying to drive it right down through his throat. Harley Race, get him out of there! Get that man out of there!
King Harley Race had the crown back, but the biggest confrontation was yet to come. It happened at the Slammies.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
I hope we're properly dressed for tonight's special occasion, being my board. As you folks can see, I've been keeping one eye on fashion and the other eye on tonight's nominees for the best dressed ring apparel. Oh! And the nominees are, first, the Demolition, Axe and Smash. Second, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Tonk Man. Fourth, King Harley Race. And fifth, the British Bulldogs. And the winner is No, this can't be right. It's right? Well, I'm not going to read it. Here, you read it.
King Harley Race?
Well, it happened. The king would like to thank all
the low-life 8-to-5 humanoid subject. And even this discount store low-life back here who's holding his board in his hand. But you see, the king can't accept this slammy unless he is properly presented with the slammy. That is woodpecker breath. You have to get down on your knees and show proper respect like this, Hacksaw.
Go away, this man's bald. Go away.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gorilla Monsoon.
Oh my God, did you see that?
Is that thing plugged in? Let me have that. While the action is taking place back here right by Pierre's makeup area, he's long gone. In fact, this whole area is cleared out. All those workers have all run for cover. Look at that. The brain in the dumpster right where he belongs. Boy, has he made a shambles of this black tie slammy affair. He's made it. He's disgraced everyone. Look at these chemicals that they're throwing at each other. Right in the eyes and the mouth. Oh. Harley, I don't think he can see. The king may be blinded out there. This feud has been going on here in the World Wrestling Federation for the past 6 or 7 months, and obviously a long way from being over. Boy, these guys have got a real hatred for each other. Oh, look at that. Some kind of powder chemical right in the face of Duggan. And now chickens, donkeys at the slammies? I don't understand that at all. They're going at it. The brain has just disgraced himself completely here. He's screaming from the background. Notice, he's not getting too close to Hacksaw. Chickens gone flying here at this first black tie affair in the World Wrestling Federation. And the king is down. Oh, right by the throat. Give it to him good, Duggan. Look at the brain now, down right next to the donkey. I don't understand what a donkey's doing here at the slammies. Look at the brain, right underneath the donkey, running for his life now. I knew sooner or later he'd make an ass out of himself. Right into the electrical utility area. Give me a break. Hundreds of thousands of volts supplying the stage area from that area. Where's the security? We need some security guards back here. Right on top, somebody could get electrocuted here. In the meantime, Brutus the Barber's on stage making the presentation for Best Head, and we're going to bring you that result as soon as we get it. But they're still going on. Hammer and thong here. Who knows where those electrical lines could be running in this room. Right face first. Look at the brain. Why don't you get in there, you coward? Still slugging it out. There's that big scream by the Hacksaw, and he's unloading now, right after right. Oh, and the king ram. Oh, here come the results now. It's a tie for the best head, Bam Bam Bigelow. And King, no, it's Bam Bam Bigelow and me, Gene Okerlund. Yes, if they only knew what was going on back here. Folks, we're going to try to keep you abreast of all this action back here, but oh, look at that. But right now, let's take you back to our Slammy's presentation. It's still mayhem here as both of these guys trying to literally take each other out of the picture. And this one looks like it's a long way from being over. It's unreal. They're trying to completely dispel. What? A llama? Who knows what's yet to come here? I'm holding you directly responsible for this brain. We'll be back with an update right after this. Gorilla Monsoon back here at the Slammies. We're still back here, backstage area in the electrical utility room where all that electricity is flowing around in there. Who knows what could happen? This thing may be just about over as Bobby the Brain Heenan has just locked the Hacksaw inside that particular utility area. There's still no security anywhere in sight. Listen to Duggan. He wants Race. He wants him in the worst way. The Brain trying to get the king out of there. Duggan going up to, oh, look at, Harley is exhausted. The king is completely exhausted. Look out, Duggan shoving all these boxes. Buried underneath all that cardboard. The Brain and the king completely buried. And Hacksaw, he's gone over the top. Here he comes like a wild man. Oh boy, did he nail him right in a kisser. Give it to him. Oh, he just boxed the Brain. I'm sure nobody wants to find that under their tree. Now they're headed out of here. Hey, I'm running out of microphone cord. Give me some more line. As they're headed for the dressing room area, in the costume area. I'm out of cord. I can't go any farther. keep those cameras rolling. Superstars here as Bobby the Brain Heenan and King Harley Race have made a shambles of this most prestigious 1987 Slammy Awards. This is not what we expected to see, folks. Now they've reached the pinnacle. They're up here. They can't go any higher. They're on the top floor. This is the room where later on tonight was supposed to be the big Christmas cast party. Imagine what all these wrestlers, their wives, or their girlfriends are going to think when they find out what's happening up here. They're destroying all the food, all the preparation work that went into this. I can't believe it. This is too much. That donkey should have sat right on that ass, Heenan. Right now, they're doing a number. Look at these poor guys, these caterers. Look at this, Hacksaw now. He's got him up with an atomic drop right into the carrot cake.
Please.
Bobby the Brain Heenan, what a slime. What a piece of garbage. What a shambles. What a mess he's made of this most prestigious event. Look at that. Ah, big fish right in the kisser. Look out. Ah, please. Still going crazy in there. Needless to say, there'll be no Christmas party this year for the cast. Much more to come from the Slammies.
Hey, Jesse, that was really great. But among all those hits, how can we possibly pick the greatest?
I've narrowed it down to five nominees, and you can read them, Chrome Dome. What?
Gentlemen, we apologize for this interruption in tonight's program and hope you will enjoy yourself as the Slammies continue.
Well, I guess it's time to get on with the reading of the nominees. Our first nominee is none other than Andre the Giant.
Propelling Hulkamania to even greater heights.
Secondly, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
I'm bored of that guy.
Yeah, so is Harley Race. Number three, the Honky Tonk Man.
It's got a good beat, but the Macho Man's not much on his feet.
Number four, Strike Force.
Strike Force, Strike Fire, move on, Mean Gene.
Bam Bam Bigelow.
Spam Spam, he's a flash in the pan. And the winner is...
interesting.
Aw, I can't believe this. Yeah, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
All I can say is,
the scene was set. Let's take you to Madison Square Garden. Hacksaw Jim Duggan versus Harley Race.